Hey, welcome to the channel, More Dirt, More Distance. In this video, I'm reviewing the Cascadia 4x4 hood solar panel for the Jeep JT Gladiator or the Jeep JL Wrangler. I installed the solar panel on my 2020 Jeep Gladiator Django back in June of 2021, so I've had about 7 months of experience using it. Over the last 7 months, I've done a lot of different camping trips, so I feel like I have a good amount of experience with it to give you a good, honest review and let you know if the panel is a deal or a dud. My panel is 80 watts, but I just recently checked the Cascadia 4x4 site and the current model appears to be 85 watts. The entire system comes with a solar panel, an MPPT charge controller, and protective vehicle vinyl, but you can buy the panel or the panel with the vinyl or the panel and the charger. The system is designed to maintain the primary and secondary batteries, so you can run 12-volt accessories without draining your battery. It is also an emergency engine starting device. If the battery does die in as little as 30 minutes, depending on the amount of available light, you can recharge your battery enough to get going. The installation is easy. Plan on it taking about 2 hours, but if you watch my install video, you'll be able to cut the install time down. I'll put a link in the description. Start with a clean vehicle. Place the vinyl on the hood to protect the paint. I got comments questioning whether the vinyl really protects the hood. The only way to really know is to remove the panel. I'm not going to do that, so I have no idea what's happening underneath there. The panel doesn't sit directly on the vinyl because there is a 3M neoprene foam on the base of the panel to act as a thermal barrier and to protect the paint and to cool the panel. The MPPT charge controller controls how much electricity reaches the battery and prevents overcharging. There's also accessory wires so that you can connect a device to the solar controller. The controller will automatically cut power to the device if it is draining the battery. I connected my Midland GMRS two-way radio to it. If this review has been helpful so far, like and subscribe so you don't miss my next one. I'm curious how everybody else is powering their rigs when they're camping. Let me know about your setup in the comments. I've also received comments related to heat and how it affects the efficiency of the panel since it's located on the hood. I am by no means an expert in solar energy or power, but I'll share with you what I found on that particular subject. The space between the hood and the panel is supposed to provide a layer of protection, allowing air to flow and to reduce the risk of heat coming up and affecting the panel. As far as the heat in the engine bay and its effect on the charge controller, the controller has a heat sensor, so it turns the system off if it gets too hot. And that's not going to be a problem because it's hot in the engine bay when the engine is running, and when the engine is running, the alternator is charging the battery. So once you get to your campsite and park, everything cools down, the solar system kicks on and starts charging your battery. It would be nice though if there's some kind of Bluetooth connectability to the controller so you can see how efficiently the unit was charging when it is resting. I don't have any complaints about the fit and finish of the unit. It's holding up really well so far. By far, the question I get asked the most is 80 watts enough power? And my response to that is, it depends on what your needs are. I mostly do long weekend camping, 2 to 3 nights at a time. I need to power my 12-volt fridge, diesel heater, and charge small electronics. For the most part, the 80 watts has been enough. I'll share 3 separate trips and how well the panel did. I went camping in the Flat Tops area for 3 nights, and there was mud on the trail that got the panel dirty. Getting the panel dirty really did affect its performance. I tried to clean it, but I couldn't get it clean enough with what I had there. I ended up having to unplug the fridge because it was draining the battery and automatically shutting off. On another 3-night trip to Uray, there were no issues with keeping the panel clean. But my campsite was covered in trees and on the shady side of the mountain, so there wasn't much direct light when my Gladiator was sitting at the campsite. I didn't have any issues with the fridge or heater shutting down, and the truck started every morning, but the battery voltage was draining as the trip went along. The last trip was 3 nights in Moab. I didn't have any issues on this trip because there is no mud or trees in Moab, nothing but direct sunlight out there. Only powering my 12-volt fridge and charging small electronics is no problem. Powering the diesel heater at night along with the fridge starts to push the system, and it's best to have direct sunlight in the morning to really get that battery back. After using the unit for the last 7 months, here's my opinion. If you're a serious overlander, the unit is not going to be enough. You're gonna need more power. But if you're looking to power a 12-volt fridge, charge your small electronics, run the diesel heater, the panel will be able to take care of that for you and your vehicle will start every morning. There is a downside though of making your vehicle your only source of power, that being that everything has to happen around where your vehicle is located. If you had a power bank, you could take that over to a different spot where you want to cook or run some different lights and not have to be so anchored to where your vehicle is. So is the hood solar panel system a deal or a dud? Based on my personal needs, I'd have to say that it is a deal. It's done everything that I need it to do. Click this end screen to see the full install.